Hello everyone, in today's video we will learn about method overloading in Java, how to create more than one methods in a same class in Java. So we will see an example by a program. So let's start the program. First of all, we will create a class with the name MO. Okay, we have created a class with the name MO. Now I'm going to declare a variable which will store the value of sum. Okay, we are going to create few methods with the same name sum. So I have declared a variable here, int s, integer type, and the first method is void sum. This method will accept two argument. It will accept two argument, that is int a and b. Okay, now let's write the body of the method. So whatever the arguments we get, we have to add that is a and b. And what we are going to do, we are going to print the value of sum. So we will use system.out.println the method. Okay, and here we will write the sum of two numbers. And what is the sum of two numbers? That is s. So we will use concatenation operator and we will write there s. So in this way, what this method does, this method accepts two arguments, that is two integer value, and whenever it is called, it needs two argument and it will calculate sum and it will display it. Next, we are going to make another method with the same name. You can see void sum. But what is the change here that we have to observe? The change is that now this sum is getting three arguments, int c, d, e. Okay, so that is what we have to keep in mind, that the entire function heading, the function header, the method header should not be same. Otherwise, compiler will be confused and there will be error. Okay, so there should be some difference in the signature. Now C plus D plus E added, and now we are going to make some changes here in message, that is sum of three numbers, done. Let's create another method, third method with the same name, void sum. Okay, and the third method will also accept two arguments, but the difference will be what? The type of argument is different. The first one is accepting integer value, second one will accept double value, that is what? Decimal value. Now what we are going to do, we'll do what here? We are going to add the value. For that, I'm going to declare another double variable here because I want to store the value, because the variable which I have declared for storing the sum, that is integer type. So I will declare here a double variable for that. So what are the variables to be added? That is f and g, f plus g. So we need to have a variable of double type to store it. Okay, so I'll make changes here. Let's make it double, okay, ss, double ss, a new variable to store double value. Now we'll go to system.out.print where we have to display the message. We'll write here sum of two numbers, okay, sum of two decimal numbers. It will be a better message to write sum of two decimal numbers and concatenation sign and the name of the variable. So in this way, we complete all the three different methods. Means the methods are, the name of the methods are same. This is what method overloading. Okay, but there will be few changes in the parameter. Now we are going to create another class. In that class, we will declare main function, public static void main. After the declaration of main function, we are going to create an object of previous class, the class which contains all those three methods, that is MO. So for creating the object of class MO, we will write the name of the class MO, then we'll give a space and we will write the object name identifier. Let's write here OB for giving the name of object, new keyword, and then MO, that is class name, parenthesis. In this way, object is created. It's time to call the methods OB.sum. Okay, see, it depends on the kind of value we give as an argument. Okay, if we give 25 and 45, first method will be called because it is, both values are of integer type. So when we write, when we call the method sum in this way, it is, the first method will be called. Now let's go to second one. We have just copied and pasted. Now I'm just increasing a value. You can see third value 14 I have written. It means that when you call the second one, then which method will be called? The second method, which has three arguments. And now when you write 25.3 and 45.7, third one will be called because it has double value. So in this way we completed. Let's save the program. Let's go to all files. Now we are with command prompt. Let's run the program. Let's open F drive, CD, Java programs folder. Now we are inside the program folder. Now let's compile Java C M, sorry, fo.java. Java C fo.java. When we write this, program gets compiled, and after the compilation of the program, we have to run it. Java space fo. It's done. You can see here the sum of two number, three number, and two decimal number is displayed. So this is what an example of method overloading in